A queen honeybee is the single most important bee in your colony. So how do you get them? Well, in this video, I'm going to talk about a few ways that you can acquire queens for use in your colonies. And I'll just start from the top. How do you find them in the first place? Well, if you've watched a lot of these videos, you'll know that I always recommend to beekeepers, meet other beekeepers. Your best source of information, oftentimes, especially when finding equipment or colonies or bees, is to network with beekeepers where you live. Reach out to beekeepers at your local bee club. Reach out to beekeepers in your area. Ask them, where do you purchase your queens? How do you get queens? How do you ensure requeening success in your colonies? And they'll point you in the right direction. They'll give you years and years and years of knowledge condensed down to some recommendations that will really help you out as you're deciding what source of queens to use. So let me share with you how you find queens. The first way you can acquire queens is simply by purchasing mated queens. There's a whole industry that's run specifically for the purpose of producing queens for beekeepers to purchase. In the United States, we have a huge queen breeding and queen production business. The same is true in countries all around the world. Wherever you live, there is probably someone who sells mated queens in your area. When you purchase mated queens, you're getting a queen who's ready to go. This is usually the most expensive way to acquire a queen because she's the queen most ready to lead your colony, right? She's mated, she's gone through the process of starting to lay eggs. The breeder has verified that she's productive and she's producing female offspring. They have to collect them, ship them to you. This is somewhat expensive, so it can be the most expensive way to acquire queens, but it's really not that much, and there's a lot of benefits that you get out of them. Again, you get this queen who's mated and ready to go. You put her in the hive, and that's great. Many of these same commercial queen production operations will also sell you unmated queens. Now, the benefit of an unmated queen is that she's going to be cheaper than a mated queen, so it will save you a little bit of money. And to be completely honest, it's not like virgin queens come with no cost. Yes, they are somewhat cheaper than mated queens, so you can see the difference in money, but when you have to wait for her to mate, that represents lost time, lost brood, lost honey production, so it does cost you at the end of the day. But a lot of people like to do it because they can mass purchase virgin queens at a much cheaper rate, throw them into their colonies, and get some pretty good mating and introduction success rates. The third way to acquire queens is by purchase of queen cells. So those same breeders who will sell you mated queens and virgin queens will often sell you queen cells. Why would you do this? Well, queen cells are a step even below the cost of mated queens and then virgin queens. This is really the cheapest price you're going to pay for a queen. The obvious downside is that if purchasing a virgin queen costs you a few weeks because she has to mate and start laying, purchasing a queen cell costs you a few weeks more because now she has to finish developing, emerge, sexually develop, then mate, then start laying eggs. A lot of commercial beekeepers like to go the queen cell purchase route because it's much cheaper than purchasing mated queens. If you've got 10,000 colonies, you don't want to buy 10,000 mated queens. Instead, you might be interested in purchasing queen cells that are much, much cheaper. These commercial beekeepers will put these queen cells into their colonies and basically say, may the best queen win. And they're working under the assumption that more often than not, the newly emerged queen will do away with the old queen and then she'll go out and mate and life will be good. But even if that doesn't happen from their perspective, they're still like, well, they still got a queen, so it's okay. So there are pros and cons associated with going this way, but the biggest pro is just the lowered cost. A fourth way to acquire queens is to produce your own, right? As beekeepers, we know there's this process called grafting, which is where you go and take very young female larvae. You move them over into these prefabricated queen cups. Then you put those queen cups into queenless colonies that develop out those cells. They feed the larva. They push them in the direction of becoming a queen. You can be your own queen producer. You can graft. You can have breeder colonies. And all of these things that the production queen breeders do. And at the end of the day, then you can control your stocks, you can control the availability of your queens. It sounds like it saves a lot of money, but it does take some time and cost. You have to have the experience, you have to have the equipment, the supplies necessary. You have to know the timing associated with moving queen cells between colonies and where they need to be, and you've got to have the mating nucs, etc. So a lot of beekeepers just want to cut out that process and go directly to the experts who have lots of experience. Other beekeepers take the perspective that I can do this myself, and so I'm going to try it and experiment with it. If you're that beekeeper, you should try it. The system is set up for you to be able to purchase the supplies that you need and give it a try. But prepare to be a little bit frustrated, at least initially, until you get good experience producing queens this way. The fifth and final way to get a queen is simply to allow the colony to requeen itself. Right? Colonies have been requeening themselves long before there was you, or long before there was me, to worry about these things. A lot of beekeepers will just simply let their colonies requeen themselves. Now, I like that in some circumstances. For example, in summertime, when my bees aren't producing honey, I can afford for the colony to go through the requeening process. But there are other times, such as going into the honey flow or during the honey flow, I don't want a queenless period. So while it's a great, cheap way, right, it's technically free to produce a queen, it can cost you in other ways depending on the time of year it happens. So as a beekeeper, you've got to sort through all of these different ways that you can bring queens into your system. But once you have them there, then you have to learn to manage them to be maximally productive. You should experiment with all of these different ways. Many beekeepers usually side on the purchase mated queens or allow colonies to requeen themselves angle. I suspect if you try all the ways, you'll find the one that works best for you.